Sobukwe was then arrested in Orlando with other members of PAC. He was then charged with incitement. He was then taken to Pretoria Central, whereby he served 3 years there. After serving his 3 years in Pretoria Central, the government then sit at the parliament and decide about the future of Sobukwe, whether they must release him or they must take him back in Pretoria Central. But they ended up coming up with a claw that was known as Sobukwe claw, which was only meant for him. That's when they decided to take him here in the island in 1963. The house on your right hand side with the water barrel on it, this is where he was staying. He was staying alone here in the island. He was separated from the ex-political inmate that you'll be meeting for your second part of your tour. He was being looked after by 6 warders here, and the warders were given access to shoot to kill if he was running away. I won't say Sobukwe was kept as a prisoner here, Gyutu. He was wearing his own clothes. He was eating whenever he wanted to eat. He was having access for radio as well. But the only thing that was denied for Sobukwe that was very, very painful, Sobukwe was denied opportunity to talk with anyone. He was not even allowed to talk with the warders that look after him. Those that were working in the limestone quarry, coming from the maximum security prison, walking to the limestone quarry on top, they will see Robert Mangaliso Sobukwe here outside and they will treat him. Sobukwe won't treat back you too. He was not allowed to communicate with anyone. The only thing he will do is he will just scoop sand with his hand and he will let it filter. And that was the message to them that you are the son of the soil. You must fight until the end in order for you to get your freedom. But during his serving in the island, he then developed a vocal cords. His vocal cords stopped working due to he was not talking to anyone. That's when the government decided to take him in the house arrest in the place called Kimbali Harishiwe in 1969. That's where he died in the house arrest in 1978. Others say he was being poisoned in the island. Others say it's a lung cancer. As the Robben Island Museum, we are providing information of that. There are many ex-political inmates that fight against apartheid in South Africa. Why not everyone is being recognized as the same level as that Nelson Mandela, Govan Mbeki, Walter Sisulu, Chris Hani, Desmond Tutu, and many more. The likes of Robert Mangaliso Sobukwe must be at least be recognized in South African history too, due to they play huge part in our freedom as a nation. 2 years after Sobukwe was released in the island, there were dog kennels that were built here. These that are facing Sobukwe's house with two windows, these were dog kennels for dogs. It's about 32 German Shepherd dogs that were kept here. These German Shepherd were patrolling in the maximum security prison, whereby I will be dropping you off for your second part of your tour. Thank you.